Sadly, in 1999, Dorothy Boyer died of lymphoma. There is a possibility that the years of selenium poisoning could have caused this. There's nothing that right now science or our technology can prove beyond a reasonable doubt.
When we get people off in our job, as well as finding the guilty, that either one is satisfaction. But I will have to admit that finding murderers and getting them off the streets, they won't.
We had to show the cause of death. And the only way we can show a cause of death is forensically. And the forensics, those are scientists, those are facts, those don't lie. You can't beat forensics, you can't beat science.
The forensics were very important for this case. This case was primarily a science case. If I were to put a number to it, I would say it was probably 90% science and 10% investigation.
Ailments that her doctors thought were all in her head. That is, until she died. After her divorce, Carol Heller moved to the small town of Perry, Oklahoma, to be closer to her family. With only 5,000 residents and almost no violent crime, Perry seemed like a good place to start over. Carol was fighting a lifelong battle with manic depression, also known as bipolar disorder. Although Carol became active in the local church and developed a circle of friends, it wasn't enough.
There are a lot of people you don't feel, will feel that if they have a spouse, they want someone in their life. And she wanted a man.
So Carol decided to place a personal ad in a local Christian newspaper.
She was looking for a Christian male person who could take charge of household finances, and Dennis was the one that answered the ad.
Dennis Heller was a 51-year-old handyman. When the two started dating, Carol's family made sure Dennis was aware of her past.
My parents talked to him about it, so he was aware that she had had some mental health problems.
Within a year, Carol and Dennis were married. And it wasn't long before some of Carol's old demons resurfaced.
She'd wander away from my house and would go find her and take her back home. Sometimes she would end up in the emergency room at the hospital. Sometimes she was taken to a mental health facility. Free evaluation, they were trying to get her on medications.
And my dad asked her one time, said, Carol, have you ever thought about killing yourself? And she says, well, yes. She said, I have thought about it before.
Doctors prescribe lithium, a common medication for bipolar disorder.
Like me. bipolar. She had a lot of manic phases, but as far as being real depressed, she handled that pretty good.
The medication caused nausea, drowsiness, and slurred speech. Her doctors reduced her dosage of lithium, but her symptoms persisted. To get relief, Carol sought the advice of other doctors, but none were able to help her.
She had been in Perry, Stillwater, Ponca, Oklahoma City, and Denver, Colorado hospitals in those 10 months. I think the doctors and nurses who treated her tended to turn around after a while.
She went to the hospital and they stabilized her.
What? I'm coming.